In this video, I show you how to make this lovely, cute cupcake beanie in toddler size. For this beanie, I use a weight 3 light yarn, hook size 6mm J hook, tapestry needle, scissor, and stitch marker. For other sizes and more info, you can find the free written pattern on my website. I will put the link in the description below. I start with gray, leave a longer tail end, make a slip knot. We work bottom up, and with this tail end, we can close this side later on. We make 54 chains. For this pattern, we need a multiply of 6. Chains twist easily, so to prevent the chain from twisting, I hold it tight in between my fingers and pull softly till I reach the end of the chain. A slip stitch in the first chain. Insert the hook, yarn over, pull the loop through. Row 1, chain 2. They do count as a stitch. Half double crochet in every chain till the end of the row. Yarn over, insert the hook, yarn over, pull the loop through, yarn over, pull through all 3 loops. We're at the end of row 1, the last stitches. We have 54 stitches. Now we work continuous rows, the half double crochet in the back loops only. Yarn over, in the back loop of the second chain from the starting chain, yarn over, pull the loop through. Yarn over through all 3 loops. And we put a stitch marker in the first stitch. Yarn over, insert the hook in the upper loop. Yarn over, pull the loop through. Yarn over through all 3 loops. Every stitch all the way down. I'm at the end of row 2, last stitches. And now we repeat row 2 till row 19. We're at the end of row 19. Now we continue with the cupcake part. First row is in every stitch a half double crochet. Insert the hook through both loops. Place the stitch marker. This is my first stitch. Half double crochet in every stitch. And I see you at the end of this row. We are at the end of row 1. And now in the last stitch, I work a slip stitch instead of the half double crochet. Insert the hook, yarn over, pull the loop through. chain 3 and turn our work. Those chains do count as a stitch. And now we work all the row double crochet. So yarn over, insert the hook, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over through the first two loops, yarn over through the last two loops. I'll see you at the end of this row. We're at the end of row 2 and the last one in the first stitch of our previous row. We can take the stitch marker out. Now a slip stitch in the third chain from the starting chains. Cut the yarn and fasten off. We just did row 2, the slip stitch, cut our yarn, and now I turn my work. You can weave in these ends immediately, but I prefer do it afterwards. Row 3, the cake row, I take the brown yarn and we start in a third stitch. Chain 3. And a double crochet in the same stitch. This one counts as a stitch. Double crochet in the next stitch. And two double crochet in the next. Chain 1. Skip 3 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 2 double crochet in the same stitch, one double crochet in the next, and 2 in the next. And this is what we repeat all row. Chain 1. Skip 3 stitches, 2 double crochet in the first stitch, 1 double crochet in the next, and 2 double crochet in the third. And I see you at the end of this row. I'm at the end of row 3, the cake row, the last cake. Chain 1 and the slip stitch in the third chain. Cut the yarn and fasten off. Now we have 9 cakes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Turn our work. Start in the first cake stitch, in the front loops only. This is the V, only in the first loop. For this toddler version, lacing row, I change to a lighter teal. Chain 1. This one counts as a stitch. In every stitch, single crochet in the front loops only. And around the chain, in between the cakes, one normal single crochet. And this is what we do all row. And I see you at the end of this row. We're at the end of row 4. Slip stitch in the first stitch. Cut the yarn and fasten off. And turn our work. Row 5, we start in line with the cake in the first stitch. For the topping, we change to white. 2 chains in the first stitch. Now we make a cluster of 5 stitches. So this is our first half stitch. Yarn over, insert your hook in the next stitch. Yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over through the first 2 loops. Don't finish this stitch. Yarn over, insert your hook in the next stitch. Yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over through the first 2 loops. Now we have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over, insert the hook in the next stitch. Yarn over, pull up the loop. Yarn over through the first 2 loops. Yarn over, insert your hook in the next stitch. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over through the first 2 loops. Now we have 5 loops on our hook. Yarn over, pull through all. 6 change. Skip the next stitch. And again, we make a cluster of 5 stitches. Six change. We repeat this till the end of the row. We are at the end of row 5, the topping row. Chain 6. And slip stitch in the first cluster. Cut the yarn and fasten off. And here's our cupcake. Again, we turn our work. We change to gray. We work in the chain bow. Chain 3. 1, 2, 3. It's our first stitch. 5 double crochet. One, two, three, four, five, six. In every chain space, 6 double crochet. We do it all row. We're at the end of row 6. Slip stitch in the 3rd chain from the starting chain. Cut our yarn and fasten off. We have 54 stitches again. external work. And now it's repeat row 3, 4, 5, and 6 two more times. We're at the end of the third row 6, so row 14 in the pattern. Make a slip stitch in the third chain from the starting chain. Row 15, chain 2, so first stitch, half double crochet in every stitch. And I see you at the end of this row. We are at the end of row 15. And close with a slip stitch in the second chain. Leave a longer tail end to close this side of the beanie. Fasten off. Now we turn the beanie inside out and weave in all ends of the color changes. Continue weaving in your ends. Now I turn the head back with the good side out. So now we close the bottom and the top of the head. Hold tight. Now I go to the other side. Hold tight. I close both ends, so now I put this gray to the inside. And here's our cute cupcake hat. If you like, you can add a pom-pom. I love making videos to show you how I work, and I thank you for all your lovely comments, feedback, and shared pictures of your finished items. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you next time. Bye!